Hello there. I'm in a tent. Okay, so this video is me reading you stories. Sorry if you can't really see my face. It's 11:30 at night. So, I'm using this for my light. It's very, bright. Just kidding, it's not bright at all. So, I was bored and I decided that I would look up stupid, scary stories to read, you know, to set the mood. When it's in the middle of the night, almost, and there's cars driving in the middle of the night. Why are you driving? It's in the middle of the night. Go to bed. Jeez. There's 8 stories, and I'm just gonna read them to you. So, I'm just gonna put this down here to get the mood. Okay. The first story. Here we go. Oh, no, that's not it. Two brothers were sitting in their bedroom one evening. Suddenly, they looked up at the ceiling and saw a small yellow spot appear in the middle. The boys watched in horror as the yellow spot grew larger and larger. Probably can't see my face. Now you can. The boys ran up to the attic and opened the door. When they turned on the lights, they screamed. There, in the corner, stood their father. And he was peeing on the floor. Next story. Okay. Once upon a time, a brother and a sister went camping. They didn't have any parents, so they went camping alone. Great. Be safe. Okay. In the middle of the night, they heard some strange noises outside their tent. They thought it was bears, so they fired shots from inside the tent. Who does that? They heard some noises that sounded like two bears dying from gunshot wounds. At dawn, the next morning, they went outside and discovered that it wasn't bears at all. It was actually their parent who had tracked them down because they loved them so much. And it says that they didn't have parents. Now they really don't. In summer 1971, a girl had just turned 16 and found out she was pregnant. Ooh, girl. After the baby was born, she realized that she was too young to be mother. Really. Okay. Anyway, so she decided to put her baby in the freezer. A few years later, oh my god, she met a nice man. Well, I'm assuming the first guy didn't end so well, considering. Got married and felt that she was ready to have a child. She took the baby out of the freezer and felt that she was ready to have a child. She took the baby out of the freezer and tried to heat it up in the microwave, but it was already dead. That person needs to go to a mental place where mental people go. One night, a man was walking down the street, and something caught his eye. There was a trail of blood leading into a dark alley. He followed the trail and found a bloody doll with blonde hair lying on the ground. He picked it up, but immediately slipped and fell over, narrowly missing impaling himself on a nail by an inch. I think it's supposed to be nearly. He knew the doll had dark powers, so he selfishly thrust it into the hands of a young girl. I have a very strange mind, and I thought it was going to go somewhere else. Who was passing by? The next day, he heard on the news that a young girl had been mugged in a dark alley the night before. Her eyes had been gouged out so that she couldn't identify the criminals. He felt guilty because it had been his... Okay, it's cut off. Oh, it fault. Okay. That the girl was mugged. The man immediately ran to the hospital and volunteered to donate his eyes to her. Aww. When he woke up after surgery, the man was shocked. He couldn't see a thing. Really? What did you do to me? He asked the doctor. I only wanted to donate one eye. But you only had one eye to begin with, replied the doctor.
Such a sad story.
It's heartbreaking. There was a person who liked nothing, so he died. Best story ever. Two kids were walking through the woods. Suddenly, a tree fell on both of them and squished them to death. But the kids didn't die instantly. They lived for several painful hours. I'm sorry to hear that. In the morning, the neighbors called the police because they had heard some screams. Once the police got to the scene of the accident, they realized that the tree was actually the, wait, what? They realized that the tree was actually the kid's father and arrested him for murder. So let me get this straight. Their father fell on them and killed them. Insert fat joke here. One cloudy autumn afternoon, a guy was driving down a desert why do I keep on messing up on them? It's country. I'm having issues here. It's deserted. Somebody help me. Okay, deserted county road. Country. Okay, anyway, he stopped to pick up a hitchhiker. She was a pretty girl, and she seemed real nice. I know I'm starting to talk in this accent, but I am. He dropped her off in the front of her house. The next day, he realized that she had left her sweater in his car. Oh no! He tried it on, and although it was warm, it had horses on the front, and he hated horses when early. On the front, so he decided he didn't want it. Oh, he must have hated horses then. But then, to his horror, he couldn't take it off. Dun, dun, dun. That night, as he slept, he was sure that he could hear the horses saying, hum, 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 hum. No matter how much food he ate, he kept losing weight. But the horses kept getting fatter and fatter. Eventually, he happened to look down and screamed. When he noticed the horses had human faces, then the guy died. So this is the last story. One time, a guy got onto a glass elevator. He pushed the button for the 10th floor. The doors closed, and the elevator went up. The indicator light climbed higher. 8, 9, 10, 11. The elevator didn't stop on the correct floor, nor did it stop at all. Dun, 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 Tower of Terror. I love that ride. But when it did stop, it doesn't make sense. It didn't stop at all, ever. But then it did stop. You have some explaining to do. The elevator didn't stop on the correct floor, nor did it stop at all, ever. But when it did stop, the man was a skeleton. That's the internet for you. Probably can't see my face at all, but I like the lighting. It's like, I'm gonna go to bed now. Alright. Bye-bye.